Hey guys, welcome to another vlog. Weekly vlog time. I'm going to a hen do tonight and it is a PJ party. So I've never been to one of these before. I mean, I know what it entails, but yeah, I've never actually been to a hen do where we just chill in our PJs, really. I don't think it's always been an eye out. So it's going to be interesting. We've had to buy some pajamas so that we're all matching. I'll show you what I've got here. It's a cute little bag that it comes in.
It's very cute, pink little PJs, and we are allowed to wear dressing gowns. So I'm going to be bringing my dressing gown and some slippers. I know some people call it your house coat, but in the north we call it a dressing gown.
So I packed those pyjamas and quickly went to my sister-in-law's house because she has a beautiful new bulldog. I'm an absolute sucker for puppies, same as my dad. This is little Ralph, he's 8 weeks old. He's so cute and he's got so many little wrinkles on him. So I went to my friend's house where it's being held, but she had no idea it was being held here. So her sister and friends organised this amazing hen party. Lots of little cute decorations everywhere you look. And we were just waiting for her to come home from her lunch. It was 5 days until the wedding here, so very, very close to the wedding. They did have to rearrange their wedding twice, but they finally did it. So it meant even more to all of us to celebrate with her. As you can see, she was extremely surprised. So we quickly got her changed into her bride pajamas with a little garter and she was absolutely buzzing. Just very, very shocked. It was a real surprise.
And I hope you don't mind that it's a bit rude, but it is a hen do.
We then played games like an egg and spoon race. We also played a riddle game and we played Never Have I Ever, which is a drinking game about things that you've done in the past, and gave her lots of little things to keep for memories. Oh, and I also got thrashed at beer pong by this team. They were absolutely brilliant. I will hold my hands up. The hen thoroughly enjoyed herself, as you can see. And there was, of course, lots of dancing and twerking. I only knew a few of the girls, but they were all really fun. It just wouldn't be right if we didn't have the bride on a chair twerking. And then the stag came home from his stag do, and it does get a bit X-rated here, I apologise. Adele's dog, Freddie, had to get in on the action as well, dancing. I also taught the stag to twerk, but he could not do it, as you can see. He has been dressed in these clothes by the stripper that he had earlier, by the way, so that's why he's wearing a dress.
I was like, I think it's your bed dresses more often.
The next night we'd been invited to the reopening of a pub, which if you don't know, the pubs had just reopened in the UK, so it was very exciting. We had live music and my sister and her boyfriend came to enjoy the lovely free food. Not much happened the next day except that we had a chicken laksa for dinner. It was absolutely gorgeous. It's our favourite meal from HelloFresh. It's got fresh coconut milk, peanut butter. And it's just so nice when you've had a weekend of eating cake and drinking to just get some greens and some fresh coriander and herbs down you.
You okay there on the sofa? Not normally allowed on there, but we put a blanket down, didn't we? Do you want to come to bedtime or you want to stay there? Come on, bedtime. Bedtime. Oh dear, you need to sleep here. No, you won't. You'll still come upstairs in about an hour, won't you? Come see us.
The next day, I got my hair done as we were going to our friend's wedding. We were so excited about this. It was only 30 people, but we were one of the lucky ones to witness it. So we went down to Yorkshire to see them get married. Very exciting. Here's us at the services. Actually excited just to get a cake and a cup of tea at a services inside because we've not been allowed to for so long. So here is the room that we were staying in. I was not expecting much because, you know, when you think of a lodge, you just think it's very small and basic, but this was stunning. I've never seen such a cute little cozy room. We had an espresso machine, which is absolutely amazing for me because I love my coffee. We had this amazing bath looking over the window and the fields out there. It was absolutely stunning. And then just little cute wardrobes over there, and it was a very comfy bed. And then just old style sort of door and this very classic but modern style bathroom. I was absolutely buzzing with this. There's also lots of cute little touches, like we had robes on the back of the door and they left a radio on so that when you walk in, you've got like classical music playing for you, which just made it feel really luxurious and spa-like. We then went downstairs with the rest of the wedding party. We had lots of cheese and ham, literally so much cheese and ham throughout the night that just kept getting replenished because we are massive cheese lovers. And then we had some champagne, chilled with the girls, and look at this lodge. I've never seen anything so rustic and beautiful in my life. And just really enjoyed this place.
Enjoying your green juice. Miles and miles of this ground, literally acres of it. If you want to go for a walk here at Middleton Lodge, really pretty, absolutely beautiful farmhouse inside. It's decorated superbly.
And here the bridesmaids are arriving. They look absolutely stunning. Adele has the prettiest friends. She's looking absolutely stunning. I love the dress that she chose, and her flowers are gorgeous as well. It's just such a nice venue to walk down the stairs in. I get so emotional at weddings every time the music comes on and the bride starts walking. I just well up, and she looks absolutely beautiful, and they're just so perfect for each other, so it just makes it even more emotional.
Can you just watch my drink?
I don't wanna go home.